especially those who participated in this panel discussion. So that thing can be related to this. At the same time, each one has spoke about marginalized communities. It was a kind of pseudo marginal kind of discussion which happened as far as I have observed. So somebody have talked about Muslims as a marginalized community, someone have talked about Tamil or Malayali, or in this deep discussion we have about Kashmiris. So now I would like to put forward an incident that happened when I went for when I went as an intern to Dinamada, which is a Tamil newsprint. That time me and my friend went there for internship, for a month of internship. So there was a translation job that has been assigned to one of my friends. So in the translation, it was on the news was on related to Kashmir issue. So I'd like to say that word in Tamil and later I'll translate to English. It was written that it was in English. We have to translate in Tamil. It was written that Kashmir revolutionaries were fired by Indian army. The word was like this. So we have to translate into Tamil. So there is a difference between a revolutionary and a terrorist. So my friend, he translated into Purachiyalar. Purachiyalar means revolutionary. So the senior editor, he came and he shouted at him, how can he translate like this? Actual meaning is revolutionary means Purachiyalar, which means he's fighting for his freedom or revolution. So intentionally, that guy, that editor, he forced that my friend to change that revolution, that Purachiyalar into Tiviravadi. Tiviravadi means terrorist. So basically, I'm a person who's from Union, like AMU Students Union, wearing Sherwani and cap. I don't have, to be honest, I don't have guts to comment on that issue. My personal ideology is different from what I have to say right here as a responsible person from that specific post. Even our president is also here, cabinet is also here. So this kind of domination shouldn't be there in press point of view. Like if you are reporting or like editing or something, translating whatever you do in journalist point of view, you should remove your nationality, lineation or something from your heart. You should be an independent journalist. So that's what Madan Gauri Sahib has said, he's trying to, but he couldn't. So that I'd like to put forward. Like you should translate, give the exact translation, not the ideological translation. That's what we are observing in current the journalistic point of view. And then there's an example of in Tamil media, there are these 20 people who went for cutting trees, sandalwood trees in Andhra, they have been shot dead. Actually, there was no proper investigation. Without proper investigation, national media started portraying that 20 smugglers are arrested. And Tamil media started making news, 20 Tamils are arrested. And there is one girl from Tamil Nadu who has been forced killed. I mean, central government forced killed. She didn't suicide, but she fought for the abolition of NEET exams from Tamil Nadu. Because NEET gives opportunities only to the specific 3% of population. I mean, I don't want to mention their name. But when Anita died, honestly, to be Madan Gauri or me or some of his colleagues, I don't know. Nobody knows that she was Dalit or not. We consider her as beloved Tamil sister, but national media portrayed her as Dalit girl was Dalit girl committed suicide on NEET issue. Then we came to not laugh that she is Dalit. We don't know whether she is Dalit or Muslim or Hindu or Christian. We just fought for major YouTubers. Even many of his friends were fought for Anita's issues. So as everyone knows, now we came to know that she's a Dalit. This is called marginalization, which we actually want to talk. Then last one is I've observed still the 10% of reservation that have come that will be introduced by Modi. So in that I've seen from as far as from my birth till now I have observed something. When a Brahmin succeeds in higher post or something, he'll be praised he's a kind of nationalist and he's treated as more than a god or something like that. So at the same time, when a Dalit comes to, at least not Brahmins here, Dalit comes from here to here, they portray the Dalit as urban Naxal just because he's been educated, he's trying to move forward. The 10% of reservation is also an example. So here, Dalits have been marginalized very badly. For example, UP and Tamil Nadu, I've seen some difference. UP has majority number of Muslim population. Tamils have one of the least number of Muslims in India, as far as we know. Even when compared to Muslims, Christians are more in Tamil Nadu. So, but Muslims in Tamil Nadu and Kerala have more number of opportunities. fulfilling their demands by being good with the government, I mean, good with other community people. But here in UP, we shouldn't directly go for demand our rights directly as a Muslim. We should go through Dalits' rights. That's how we are going to succeed. There is a saying that we should live and then live. We should let others live and then live. So through others.